Hey everyone, it's Divine Readings with the Gypsy, and it's really late here in the States, so I'm only gonna try to make this video real brief, and I know I say make it brief, but I promise this time it's gonna be more brief, just because I crush over all my decks in my decks collection in one way or another, but I picked out my top five decks that I'm crushing over at the moment. And when I'm really using really hardcore, and this list is not going to surprise many of you, but for those who are new to my channel, this is something that you will grow to see my channel a lot more often, probably. And the first order of business is the Rorik Tarot. The Rorik Tarot is definitely a wonderful, wonderful deck, if you could see that. It's beautiful, it reads real well with the ruins. It also is very good with the, what is it, Romney spread. It's very beautiful with the Romney spread, and it all laid out on the table. And it's really great for relationships and client reading as well as self-reading. It's wonderful. I trimmed it, and I guess you could see the bronze edging that I made. I gotta redo the bronze edging. It's not the greatest, but it fits the deck very, very nicely. If you see it right here, you see that? I like it. So that's my Rorik Tarot, and I'm thinking about getting a second copy. And of course, my Thoth deck is one I've been crushing over. And I've actually been crushing over this version. I have two Thoth decks. One is the regular size Thoth deck, untrimmed. And this one, I decided to go ahead and just trim it all. Just so I could have this as a pip deck for myself, so I could read. And I know pretty much all the cards in this deck, so it was easy to convert this to a pip deck and me knowing all the cards. And I could use this as in a different form or a different light, so I don't have the Thoth influences on it, so to speak. So it's a good way to take something that you love and make it something you want to read with a little bit more. So I'm crushing over the fact that I trimmed it the rest of the way, and crushing over the fact that I could use it more than one way now. Alright, and then another deck that I'm really crushing over, and I think a lot of people are crushing over right now, is my Tabla Mundi Tarot. It's basically a Thoth clone. It's not really a Thoth clone. I think it kind of has a Thoth structure, but it does its own thing, and it's wonderful. And I love the keywords with the court cards, because that's how I read the court cards. I love the fact that it does the swords and interference and the associations, because it's, for most sakes, an argument. It's a Thoth themed or structured deck, but it's not like in your face constantly that it's Thoth, and you have to read it Thoth. You could actually read it your own way. And I have done the Romney spread with this one, and it reads pretty good. I think it reads like the Thoth in that way. I wasn't crazy about it in the Romney spread. I kind of like almost a three-card reading, but I have to get to know this deck a little bit more. This deck and I, we don't really know what our voice is yet. We're in the new stage, new lover stage, so to speak. So it's a new crush. And one I have been crushing over for quite some time, and I'm feeling the energy of whipping it out again, is my Pagan Otherworlds. The reason why I'm crushing over this one is because, yes, it's a Rider-Waite pip. I think it gets too much slap for what it is. I think it is, I'm not trying to be mean to Kelly from Truth and Story, but I feel like this deck has gotten more slap than it deserves. I really love the fact that it's a Rider-Waite Pippi deck, but you definitely could read it more Pippi if you wanted to. It's not strictly Rider-Waite Pippi. You can read it with it and branch off with it in your own way, because that's kind of how I read. I branch off and do my own way, and this deck has no qualms on just branching out and doing your own solo way, and it still has the tarot structure to it. So, and plus the cardstock is the best cardstock in the world. It's playing cards. I edged this in a very, if you could see, it's seamless with no white, harsh white borders. And I love it. I love it. It gives it that nice aged look. I edge it in a Winsor Newton marker. I need to do my Winsor Newton. It's kind of sad that that was the only use I could, the deck that came turned out really nicely with that Winsor Newton marker. And if one follows my channel enough, you will know that that Tarot Prague is always on the prowl for me. This deck is starting to get some miles in it. I don't know if anybody, you can't really tell from this angle or from my Instagram pictures, but if I start showing the edges, let me see if I can start showing edges on my Tarot Prague real quick. But if I start showing you my edges on this deck, you could tell it's starting to get its miles in. If you look here, I don't know if you can see, I had a wine spill incident, and there's a purple card right there. Yeah, and I think it was my Nine of Wands got it pretty good. But yeah, I had a wine spill, and you could tell that my edges are starting to get a little worn, which is okay. That tells me that I'm actually using the deck, and I'm actually using it to its max, and I don't regret one moment without it. I do have a backup copy of this deck now, so it's not like I'm abusing it without any reason, and I love the fact. This is definitely my love of my life, favorite collage deck. I crush over this all the time, every time I pick it up. Cardstock is wonderful. Cards are beautiful. It shimmers in the sunlight. Definitely crushing over this. And so those are my five decks that I'm crushing over, really, at the moment. The cards that I don't have that I'm crushing over are some of the cards that are on my wish list. For an example, the Orb of Full Tarot is something I've been crushing for a long time. Long distance crush. I've actually been crushing over the Crone Tarot and the Goddess Tarot. For once, it wouldn't be Kelly made me do it. It would be Wild Moon Woman made me do it. I've been crushing those cards at it for a long time. I just took them off my wish list and radar because it was not something I would pay uber amount of money just to get my hands on the Goddess Tarot or the Crone Tarot if it was out of print. And it was out of print for a little while. What else have been on my wish list that I've been crushing over? I was crushing over the Brute Tarot a little bit, but I had some piggy bank money, and now I think I'm going to use that for the Brute Tarot because it's playing cards. Playing cards were also one of my first loves, and now I can make that dream into reality to get a tarot card playing card set almost. So that's something I'm very excited about that I will be purchasing soon. Not yet, but soon I'll be purchasing. What else have I been crushing over? I've been crushing over some of my other decks too, but those are my major ones that I've been crushing over. But Okay, I just need to call it a night, and then I'll see you all tomorrow and day 17.